सॉल्यूशन ऑफ टेस्ट 12. नाउ दिस टेस्ट 12 इंक्लूड अ चैप्टर दैट इज डाइजेशन एंड एब्जॉर्प्शन. दैट इज द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ यूनिट ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी. सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद इट्स सॉल्यूशन. Question 1 asks that intestinal villi are more numerous. Intestinal villi are more numerous, means they are large in number and larger in, and they are larger in size as well, in posterior part of small intestine than in anterior part, because now intestinal villi are helping in absorption and in posterior part there is a more digested food. So C is the correct answer, that there is a more digested food in posterior part. So C is the correct answer, because it get a more digested food. Question 2 asks that in gluconeogenesis, so we have to select a correct option. Now first we should understand, what do you mean by gluconeogenesis? Gluconeogenesis is a process in which glucose is formed or synthesized from substrate other than carbohydrate. Means if glucose is getting synthesized from the fat or protein, then this process is known as gluconeogenesis. So option A is given as glucose is polymerized into its glycogen, so is there is no synthesis of glucose, there is a polymerization of glycogen, so it is incorrect. B is given as glycogen is broken down into glucose, but glycogen is a carbohydrate, so formation of glucose from carbohydrate cannot be considered as gluconeogenesis. C is given as carbohydrates are synthesized from amino acid, means amino acid is giving to form carbohydrate, so it is a correct statement, dear students. And D is given as glucose is broken down into pyruvic acid. So if glucose is broken down, it is a glycolysis, it is not a gluconeogenesis. So C is the correct answer. Next is question 3. Question 3 asks that the function of vitamin A is. Function of vitamin A is. Now if you talk about function, option A is given as vitamin A maintain the integrity of epithelial tissue. Yes, actually vitamin A maintains surface tissue and epithelial tissue are also a surface tissue. So the integrity is maintained by vitamin A, it is correct. Option B is given as to regulate the growth of the body, especially the skeletal and connective tissue. Yes, it regulates the growth of skeletal and connective tissue. C is given as to help the body from a prevention on infection. Yes, it prevents from the infection and it increases the immunity. So it is correct. And D is given as all of the above. So all three are correct. So D is the correct answer. That is all of the above. Next is question 4. Question 4 asks that anti-xerophthalmia vitamin is. Anti-xerophthalmia vitamin is. Now xerophthalmia occurs due to the inhibition in synthesis of retinal pigment. Now to recover xerophthalmia, vitamin A is used, as vitamin A is also known as retinal, and this vitamin A or retinal is essential for synthesis of retinal pigments and it promote normal vision. So vitamin A, that is option A, become correct answer, which used against xerophthalmia. Question 5 asks that fundic part of stomach is so if we know stomach is usually get divided into three parts, that is fundus region or fundic stomach, second is central body, and third is pyloric stomach. Now if we talk about the fundic stomach, its larger anterior part is called the cardiac stomach, while the shorter, narrower posterior part is known as pyloric stomach. So it is a posterior part, it is an anterior part. So fundic part is absent in stomach of frog. So fundic part is present in rabbit and absent in frog stomach. So A is the correct answer. Question 6 asks that which of the following shows correct pairing for salivary gland. Now if we talk about salivary glands, there are three salivary glands are that. One is parotid gland, and this parotid gland and buccal mucosa are connected by parotid duct, and this parotid duct is also known as Stenson duct. Second is found as submandibular or Wharton duct. Submandibular or Wharton duct connect submandibular gland to floor of mouth. And third is known as sublingual gland. This sublingual gland drains through numerous small duct which opens into mouth. Now this numerous small duct are collectively called as duct of Ravenous. So if we match according to this, then option D is correct, and parotid is matches with the duct of Stenson, submaxillary matches with the Wharton's duct, and sublingual matches with the duct of Ranvier's. So D is the correct answer. Question 7 asks that crypt of Leiberkühn is an example of. Now crypts of Leiberkühn is a type of simple tubular glands in which secretion portion is secretion portion is straight and tubular. So the script of liver cones are a simple tubular gland. So option A is correct answer. Next is question 8. Question 8 asks that which one of the following set is a polysaccharide group? Polysaccharide group set. Now option A is given as glucose, fructose and lactose. Now glucose, fructose and lactose. Glucose is a monosaccharide, fructose is also monosaccharide, and lactose is also a monosaccharide. So it is not a polysaccharide group. B is given as starch. Starch is a polysaccharide. Glycogen is a polysaccharide. Cellulose is a polysaccharide. So it is a correct. C is given as sucrose. Sucrose is a disaccharide. Then maltose is a disaccharide and glucose is a monosaccharide. So this is not a polysaccharide set. And D is given as galactose. Galactose is a monosaccharide. Starch is a disaccharide and sucrose is a disaccharide. So it is also incorrect. So all disaccharide are starch, then glycogen and the cellulose. So B is the correct answer. Question 9 asks that chymotrypsin is. Now if you talk about chymotrypsin, it is an enzyme which break or cleave proteins. So this is known as proteolytic enzyme. So option A is correct answer. Next is question 10. Question 10 asks that which one of the following is the correct pairing? Correct pairing of the site of action and substrate of renin. Now renin is an enzyme which act on a substrate that is casein, and this casein is produced in the stomach part. So A become the correct answer. Question 11 asks that the pungent odor of feces is due to presence of. So if we talk about the odor of feces, it is due to the presence of toxins. It is due to the presence of toxic amines that are indol and scatol derived from action of bacteria on amino acid. Gases are also responsible for this odor, and they are produced by a fermentation of carbohydrates. So these gases are produced by a fermentation of carbohydrates. So if we go according to the option, option A is given as indol, option B is given as scatol, option C is given as various gases, and option D is given as all of the above. So all of the above is correct answer for pungent odor of feces. Next is question 12. Question 12 asks that pepsin is an example of. Now pepsin. Pepsin is a proteolytic enzyme. It is a proteolytic enzyme
produced by a stomach, and that is responsible for the beginning the digestion of protein. So this proteolytic enzyme carry out digestion of protein, and this pepsin act as a enzyme. An enzyme is given is option C. So the enzyme become correct answer. Question 13 asks that fatty acid are first incorporated into small droplets called, okay, fatty acid are incorporated into droplets are called as, and they are reformed into very small protein coated fat globules known as. So now if we deal with this question, when fatty acid form droplets, they are known as micelles. Now micelles are nothing but they are the lipid molecule, and this lipid molecule arrange themselves in a spherical form. This molecule in a spherical form in a aqueous solution. And this micelle formation is responsible to the amphipathic nature of the fatty acid. Now fatty acid have hydrophilic head and hydrophobic tail. So this fatty acid arranged in the form of like this. So this structure is known as micelle, which is a spherical structure. Now if we go in a further question, they are reformed into very small protein coated fat globules. Yes, this micelle reform in very small protein coated flat globules, and they are called as chylomicron. Now if you talk about chylomicrons, these chylomicrons are ultra low, density lipoprotein particles, and this chylomicron consists of triglycerides, phospholipid, cholesterol and proteins, and these chylomicrons are formed in the endoplasmic reticulum of enterocyte. These are formed in endoplasmic reticulum of enterocytes. So the correct answer becomes micelle and chylomicrons which is given in option A. So option A is correct. Next is question 14. Question 14 asks that liver is called a reticular gland. Now if we talk about a liver, has a liver tissue that are made up of lots of smaller units of liver called a liver lobules. This liver has liver lobules, and in this there is a network of reticular fibers. Now and this reticular fibers, network of reticular fibers, and that tissue will be named as a reticular tissue. So if you go with the option, the shape is reticular, no, due to this it is not as known as reticular gland. Option B, they have this network of reticular fibers which are known as reticular cells, so it contain a reticular tissue, correct. C is given as lobules, branches and anastomase with one another to form network. Lobule branches not form a network, and D, hepatic duct and cystic duct unite to form the bile duct. So it is not correct. So that is due to the reticular tissue. They are known as reticular gland. Question 15 asks that the deficiency of vitamin K results in reduction of. Now you know that when a deficiency of vitamin K occurs, there is a reduction or decrease in synthesis of prothrombin. And prothrombin is a blood clotting factor. So due to reduction in prothrombin, excessive bleeding occurs due to improper clotting. So prothrombin reduction occurs in the vitamin K deficiency. So D is the correct answer.